Ladies and gentlemen, I'm told that the Maritime Safety Authority of Fiji have completed 3 boat master and class 6 licensing training on your island. And according to the MSA records, that is the Maritime Safety Authority records, all boat captains on Banga Islands have gained license to operate. This training is a government initiative in conjunction with the Maritime Safety Authority. It was the result of consultation with various stakeholders in the shipping and transportation industry. Hence, the need for the country to comply with international laws and standards concerning safety at sea for seafarers. Safety is paramount, ladies and gentlemen. While safety is everyone's responsibility as well, a lot of emphasis is placed upon the captain, who is overall accountable for the safety of all passengers and ensuring that the vessel and the operations is compliant and meets the requirement standard as far as our law goes. As a result of this training, the ministry and MSF is confident that the people of Banga traveling to the mainland are in capable hands of a certified boat master ensuring their safety. This training also creates awareness on the importance of safety at sea, which we often overlook, such as 1, informing family members of the places you are traveling to and your expected time of return. 2, check engines prior to traveling. 3, having an effective and workable communication tool is in terms of mobile phones and light and emergency supplies. And 4, no overloading. This means having the right number of passengers on board at all times. And lastly, update on weather patterns and news. Ladies and gentlemen, most sea accidents and drowning are due to the no care attitude and not to comply with the proper procedures of operating sea transport. I encourage all boat captains on Banga Island to adhere to the maritime and safety laws and put in practice what you have learned from this training. The people of Banga depend on you, and you must retain their trust by applying best practice of seafarers when operating a boat. It's not only about your dream. Government has already fulfilled your dreams. But now, the responsibility comes on you. As captains, you are accountable for the lives of your passengers. It is your principal duty to ensure safety at all times for your passengers and yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, government is committed to an inclusive policy for all Fijians, regardless of your ethnicity, your social background, your status in the community, your culture, of your religious belief. And our objective is to reach out to all Fijians, and no matter how isolated you may be, to address this issue on about safety at sea. And that is the whole reason why we are here this morning with all the teams to talk to you directly, rather than you coming to mainland. Latest figures shows that 70% of our population are under the age of 40. So in few years' time, we will depend on our youths. it will be a young nation and you will have a control on this country. You will be basically running the shows. So the time is now right for you. Take advantage of all this training that is provided by government. Take every opportunity to attend to all these workshops and seminars. This government has put in place opportunities for young Fijians to be empowered and self-sustainable through the ministry's mobile and specific skills empowerment and capacity building training program such as this. These training programs are targeted for those Fijians who cannot qualify for mainstream learning opportunities. As I've said earlier on, we don't want to leave any Fijians behind. We have seen and now we are filling that gap as a government. Before, nobody cared about you. Once you fail in your education, you go. But now, this government is going to fill that gap. If you can't make it, there will be another opportunity coming, knocking your doors. And workshops like this, whereby you can go for a training, qualify, and then you get an employment. There'll be more coming. This is just a start for the people of Benga. Ladies and gentlemen, these training programs are targeted for those Fijians, as I've said, who cannot qualify for mainstream learning opportunities. Example, a place at university or due to circumstances and cannot complete high school. This government wants to an inclusive society and believes in the foundation of equal opportunities for all and the right to the decent living. Ladies and gentlemen, in providing the boat master and class 6 license training, we are empowering you the opportunity to use your license to self-income generation. It is our hope that by generating income, it will inspire you to do more for your family and your community to a sustainable way of life. Ladies and gentlemen, this government, through the Ministry of Youth and Sports, priority is to reduce unemployment, create opportunities for youths and Fijians. And as I said earlier on, don't forget this, 70% of our population is 40 below. It is very important to remember. The responsibility is basically coming on the shoulders of our youths. And we as a government, we want to be prepared with that. It's no point only knowing the figures and don't do anything. No. The plans are already there and we're going to reach out throughout the country to our youths who can't make it to the universities and higher educations. Ladies and gentlemen, before I conclude, please allow me again to remind you on the importance of complying to the maritime and safety laws, rules and regulations. With these few words, ladies and gentlemen, I now declare the Boatmaster and Class 6 licensing training closed. Vinaka and thank you.
Maboa. Epeli mbongi timba. Rosa Ratumeyale. Mosese Naivalu.